Hello, this is Gene Thorpe at Little Red Rooster TV, and we're out here at the Little Red Rooster Ranch. And, you know, one thing I love being out in the country, you know, sometimes if I hear the cows, it's music to my ears. But anyway, I wanted to give a shout out to my friend, Terry Cruson, who probably 15 years ago gave me this document, which is called The 10 Commandments for Being a Good Lead Guitarist. And I think it's very cute, it's very helpful. And as a guitar player, when you go to jam with other people, it's great to know, kind of like have a little pattern. Okay, so number one, commandment number one, thou shalt always endeavor to make the other members of the band, especially the main performer or character of the moment, sound their best. So you always want to be embellishing. Remember that playing with others requires teamwork. Be a team player, not a self-appointed star. Okay, number two, thou shalt be humble. Because, and here's why, to any and all other lead guitar players, knowing that every guitar player knows something that you don't, you always have something to learn. Humbleness will not diminish you, but rather enhance both your playing abilities and the respect of other musicians, and make you a person that other guys want to play with. Three, this is a wonderful one. Thou shalt never play too loud. Always seek a warm balance. If you're too loud, the others will turn up to try to match you, and pretty soon the whole band starts cycling up into that rumble. And if you can keep it down, it's really amazing when you're playing, even outside, inside, wherever, how the sounds will cycle out into the room and bounce around and all of that type of thing. And there is a happy medium of volume versus the sound of the vocals and whatever kind of band you want to be. I mean, of course, if you're heavy metal, you're going to need to have that, you know, a certain amount of volume. But that's one of the main things that people do when they're starting out, is play a little bit too loud. And here's the next one. Thou shalt not overplay. Keep it clean and simple, enough to enhance your band's delivery. Your instrumentals, your solos, are the time you get to show off. And my advice is practice over the chords until you get a very nice solo that you could play every time consistently. And then, you know, when you're in one of those magical moods, you can embellish off of that solo. Learn to relax your fret hand and your picking hand. I find that when you play lighter, you can probably play faster. And when you strum with dynamics, like the guys in my band are always saying, turn the guitar down, strum harder, and, you know, therefore get a cleaner sound. Okay, so thou shalt play guitar quieter when others are performing. Okay, so this one is talking about the dynamics of, let's say Billy Bob is gonna sing. Soon as that vocal comes in, if you drop your volume slightly, it lets that vocal come out. And if everybody does that, you have dynamics in the band. I love the old R&B bands, the James Brown band, where the drummer would go pop and everybody would come down to a very low volume and sizzle. You know, always be sizzling, I think. Okay, let's see. And if the rest of the band does that for every other member, all solos are going to be clean. Number six, thou shalt never clash with other lead instruments. So if you're going to even play a signature part, what sometimes we call an ensemble part or whatever, be very careful that every note of it will be kind of in that same realm as what the lead player of that moment is playing. Because if you don't, then you get these musical, like, little muddiness, and, you know, you can go on major records and find little faux pas back in the background. It's fun to listen for those, but it's better to not have them at all. Thou shalt, number seven, commandment number seven, thou shalt understand trade-off. In general, if you're the one that kicks the song off, then another instrument will probably take the first solo. If there's more than two solos in a song, have two lead instruments play those solos instead of one playing both solos, because it just gives more variety. I even think that way in vocals. Number eight, thou shalt watch the other members of the band, particularly the one performing at the moment. So if the lead singer is going out to the front of the stage, you don't want to be thrashing around. You want to be watching each other for cues. You want to be watching each other for just whatever that they're doing. You know, you never know what's going to happen to music. Number 9, when you're jamming, thou shalt never anticipate chord changes. In other words, sort of like anticipating a chord change the first time through instead of listening. If you listen very hard, you'll find there are many alternative chords and substitutions that you can use, but you want to make sure that you're playing what the other guy's playing. It's sort of like you don't want to go out and try to finish another person's sentence before they're finished saying what they mean. Okay. Thou shalt always be ready to learn. And this is number 10. Always be in a learning mode. When you go into any situation, no matter what it is, you're going to be able to learn something. Every musician will probably be able to give you some kind of insight. In fact, one of the greatest things I've heard recently, I was talking to one of the fellows in the band, and he was saying one of his earlier influences used to say to him, let's just sit here and listen to this song. Okay, this time let's just listen to the hi-hat. Okay, let's listen to what the bass drum's doing. The bass, all of the different components. As you listen, you go deeper into what you can play. So this is Gene Thorpe on behalf of my friend Terry Nelville Cruson. Thank you, Terry, for giving the Ten Commandments of being a lead guitar player. Gene Thorpe, Little Red Rooster TV, signing out.